Death is pretty much a cut-and-dried business, Gunner. It's permanent. Except when it comes to the Waterman. His real name was Edward Schall. He was a young man when he and his wife moved to Wild Horse. Wild Horse started out as a mining town. But the only rock in those mountains were igneous rock, obsidian, worth less than iron. One day, Edward found a rock vein no one had ever seen before. Its glow was mesmerizing. But his discovery was soon forgotten, because that very night, tragedy struck the town of Wild Horse. The Wild Horse Dam broke. The flood came suddenly. No warning, no chance to escape. He and his wife, Sarah, were swallowed up. Some of the bodies floated downstream as far as Pine Mills. My father was just a boy then, about your age. He saw the carnage, saw it himself. And his father, my grandfather, he had to examine the bodies. And he declared them all deceased. That was until Edward Schall miraculously woke up. From that day on, he was known as the Waterman. And even though Wild Horse had been washed away, he moved back there. Claimed he could save his wife, if only he could find her body. He hung black stones all around the forest to mark where he'd searched. Most people thought he was crazy, except for a few, my father included, who swore they saw something in those woods. Dead animals coming back to life. They said it was proof that the Waterman's power is real. Legend has it that he's still living up by the lake, searching the waters and the woods for his wife's body, so he could bring her back from the dead. Even if all that was left of her were her bones.